Have you ever been on a lost highway that you can stand in the middle of, drive 16 miles, and not see one person? You would be at the end of Arizona 266. So why would you say that we were at the end of Arizona 266? That very reason would be this building right here. And we took this trek to the middle of nowhere. I've never been on a highway where I just is like, I'm astonished, this highway's so nice and there's nothing there. And Bonita will be on down, I believe. But right here, I came all this distance to find where another notorious outlaw that everybody knows. Nobody knew Chacon, but everybody knows this character here. Now, this building was put together in about 1930, but it's the original foundations of the original bar that's set here, where a gentleman named Francis Cahill, or his friends, which I don't think he had any, named him Windy Cahill. Now, Windy was a bully, and he was bullying this young boy that had escaped New Mexico and robbed a Chinese dry cleaner and came here to kind of hide out. But Windy the blacksmith did not care for this boy, who was William Bonney. And they had a confrontation, and they say it happened by those trees right there where this occasion happened. And they got in a brawl because Windy called Billy, or William, a pimp. And he shot him right by that tree. So the legend of a character named Billy the Kid started right here in this spot in the middle of nowhere, which was in the middle of nowhere that many years ago. But that is the exact location. And again, this building was rebuilt in 1930, but this is the exact foundations that the bar that the confrontation took place spilled out here into the yard. Billy shot him, and then that started the legend of Billy the Kid. Now, he didn't die immediately. He died like the day later. Now, we're going to go down to the grave, and we're going to go to the graveyard and see the grave of Windy, or Francis Cahill, the first person that Billy the Kid killed. Now, they say it was 21 people, but nobody can really say that that's the truth. All they say is that's what he said. Maybe it was a he said, she said. But that very tree is where Billy the Kid killed his first person right there. I tell you, this is the middle of nowhere on the Lost Highway. That is absolutely the Lost Highway right there. Look at this place. Oh, a car. I actually hear a car. Isn't that incredible? You get off the pavement to the red dirt, not very far in this valley. On the south side of the road is the Bonita Cemetery. That's a beautiful sign. It really is. Gates open. So let's go take a look. I remember there, he's right there. You can see the new stone. So that's not even a lot of work. And here is the final resting place of Francis Windy Cahill, the first kill. But you know, he was a bully, and they still said that the kid shouldn't have shot him. So he was on the run. This is a beautiful cemetery, for the people that are in this area. really interesting. You see these local cemeteries, and I mean, this is, they live and die out in this, on the land that they love. And I was going to say, I already know that's his because I watched one other video on it. So there he is right there. And if you look on the back, Historical Coalition, Billy the Kid. So they redid this tombstone. It was like this. It was scrawled in, something like that. And there's pictures online on it. So here he is right here. Francis Windy Cahill, 1846, Ireland, August 18th, 1877, first man killed by Billy the Kid. Right there. Look at this. Man, this is definitely out in the middle of nowhere. There he is. He got shot in the gut, and I think it took him a day or so to die. This is where he was laid to rest, right here. Look at all these, you know, you still don't know who these people are. Sad that the families couldn't, and these old cemeteries couldn't make sure they had headstones that put them in. So we'll look one more time at there it is. We made it. Got a lot of stuff and a lot of cover ground to cover today. So let's take a look around a little bit and go from there.